And welcome again to Cottage Talk. I am Russ Goldman. This is the debut episode of Full Media Buzz, and it is for today, May the 30th, 2023. In this episode, I'm going to be talking about several stories that are in the media that involve Fulham players, and in one case, a former Fulham player. I'm going to be sharing my thoughts. Do I believe the story? And then afterwards, if I do believe the story, would I like to see this player at Fulham Football Club? So that's where I'm going to go on this episode of Cottage Talk to get us going. I'll be doing several shows of Full Media Buzz. This one is actually just going to be recorded, but I will have several that will be live. As always, please do subscribe on YouTube and Apple Podcasts. It does help other Fulham supporters find us. Okay, let's get going. And let's start with my number one story. And it actually broke yesterday. This is actually from the Daily Mail. It involves the Manchester United central midfielder, Fred. And here is an excerpt from an article. Man United midfielder Fred attracting interest from Fulham, with a Brazilian who could be one of 13 players leaving the club this summer. Spotted chatting to Marco Silva outside Old Trafford. Again, this story is from the Daily Mail. I've seen similar stories from TalkSport, from the Manchester Evening News. It is everywhere. I've actually seen the video of Marco Silva talking to Fred. So let's start with the story itself. Do I believe it? Am I buying it or am I selling it? I'm buying this. I think there's something to this. I don't think this gets out there to the point that it does if there's not something there. Sometimes where there is smoke, there's fire. I know part of it is involving Marco Silva spotted talking to Fred, but I think that there's more to it. So I'm buying the story. Now let's talk about, would I like Fred at Fulham Football Club? And the answer is yes. He's 30 years old. He's a central midfielder. Reading a little bit more about Fred, and it sounds like, based on what I've read about this player, that at Manchester United came with a huge price tag, and they've struggled to find the best position for him. Is he a 6? Is he an 8? Is he a 10? Based on what I was reading, it really has come down to potentially his best role is a number 8, a box-to-box central midfielder. And that would be a very good acquisition for Fulham. Nothing against Harrison Reed, but someone like Fred would give just a presence that would be similar to Pereira, would be similar to Willian on that level. I think Fulham need players that have played at top level clubs. And I think Fred would just fit in perfectly. Would he take the place of a player like Harrison Reed? Only time will tell. But I think as we look at to this new season for Fulham Football Club, how they're going to build it, I think it's interesting because part of me thinks that they need to get much younger. And I'm sure many Fulham supporters listening to this are going to say, Russ, he's too old. I think in this case, and there are going to be a few cases where I think you need to balance someone that will help you stabilize Fulham, like a Fred, like a Willian, and then younger players that are going to take you to the next level. I think you need a mixture of both. I think you need young talent, but I also think, as we're seeing other clubs in the Premier League, you need experienced players, someone that has been there, done that. Fred is that. I think he has a lot to still offer, even at 30 years old. I really want to see this speculation become true and actually become a transfer. I'm all on board on Fred coming to Fulham Football Club. Now, I'm going to be reading some comments that the fans have been sharing on the Cottage Talk Facebook page and on Twitter as well, and also a poll. And one of the questions is going to be this: well, how much is it going to cost Fulham to get Fred? And interesting part of this, I went on Transfer Market to see what they have as his value. And as of last December, they had his value at 20 million euros, which honestly, I think is, for a player of his experience, I think it's not so terrible. So I think if that's the starting point, I think we can work around that. Fred is a player that I think could really help Fulham Football Club. He's not going to be at the level of a Paulina, but he could be at a level of a Willian, just someone that you could stick in and you could count on. Fulham need more players like that. I think as Fulham grow in the Premier League, they need to really just solidify themselves in the Premier League, maybe for another year or two, and then really push on. This is the type of player I think that would help you solidify. So for me, I'm all in on this speculation. I would like to see Fred come to Fulham Football Club. So now I'm going to read the results of a poll I did, which was yesterday, ended today. And the poll is, if the speculation is true, would you like to see Fulham bring in Fred from Manchester United? Yes, was it 81.2%? No, was it 18.8%? And it was 511 votes. That's a good amount of votes. So that to me tells me that the majority of the supporters would like to see Fred at Fulham Football Club. And I'm one of them. I would definitely like to see it. So I do have some comments. Let's start with the first comment from a former co-host of Cottage Talk, David Holly. He says, glad to see I'm in the minority. Well, David, that is not a shocker coming from you. You like to go against the grain. So sounds like you would not like to see Fred at Fulham Football Club. This is from Dale. We're already the oldest squad in the Premier League. We shouldn't be looking at signing 30-year-olds. Dale, normally I would agree with you, but I think if you add one or potentially two players that have this kind of experience, I think it can help you. I think if you really just concentrate on older players, then that's going to hurt you. But if you're going to have one or potentially two, I don't think it's a big deal. I think it could actually help you. This is from Ronan. Fred is a hardworking player. That's what Fulham need, and that's kind of where I'm going on it. David French says, he's a dirty player who is prone to excessive gamesmanship. I don't care how good he is or if we would win more games with him in the team. It is a hard no for me. Okay, see, so we're getting some different comments about Fred. Now, this is on the Cottage Talk Facebook page. So we got some interesting comments from the Fulham supporters on the Facebook page. From Ben Lawrence, no thanks. Doesn't look good in a good side, so in a poor United side. Didn't stand out as good either. Okay, let's see what else we got here. This is from David Clark. He supplied the perfect pass to beat us yesterday. It was 2 days ago by the time I'm reading this, so thank you there, David. Lorcan McGovern says, players like Fred would probably fare better with Fulham, more likely to flourish than with United. Just like Andres Pereira. That's my point, Lorcan. I think he would thrive at Fulham Football Club. Stefan says, it depends what we pay for him. And I agree with you. I think 20 million euros, if that's within the ballpark figure, I don't think that's a terrible amount. I'd like it to be a little bit less, but I wouldn't be against that. Belinda Jackson, fine by me. So we have some that are for it and some that are against it. Leslie Bourne Mullen says, how do we know Marco is staying? It could be he is lining Fred up for his next post. Let's hope not, Leslie, but I understand where you're coming on that because that's the number one piece of business Fulham need to do this summer, sign Marco Silva to a long-term extension. Stephen George O'Keefe, yes, would mix in while I reckon. Okay, and finally, Roy Harrop says no. So I got a little bit of everything, but the poll itself was highly in favor of bringing in Fred. So that's the first piece of news I wanted to share in this debut episode. Very interesting comments from the Fulham supporters. Now let's go on to one that I've already talked a good amount on Cottage Talk about, and we're going to talk about it again because there was another article. There have been several articles. This one's in The Athletic. Quote, Tottenham targeting move for Fulham loanee Manor Solomon. And I've been reading a lot about this. I do buy the story because there have been several places where this has been, not just from The Athletic, other places as well. I've seen stories about this all over the place. So I am buying the story. What about the situation? Would I want Manor Solomon back? And this might surprise some people, but I actually don't want Manor Solomon back. I just think that Fulham need to find a player that is a complete winger at this point. Manor Solomon does have moments of magic, and I think he will do well where he ever he goes next, but he is a defensive liability. And I think that he's been found out a little bit, that you can really stop the way he wants to play, forcing him to his left and not letting him shoot on his right. So until he tackles that part of his game, I think he's more of a one-dimensional player. So I would be okay with Manor Solomon moving on. And if he wants to go to Tottenham, best of luck to him. I don't know how much he's going to play, but I'm not against Fulham not re-signing Manor Solomon. I know that, again, might surprise some people. That's how I feel. I do believe the story that Tottenham Hotspur are interested, though. I think there's something to that. Okay, let's move on. Let's now talk about a player. Yes, I've talked a lot about on Cottage Talk. It is going to be Fabio Carvalho. And this story has actually been brewing the last couple of days. So I'm going to read this. According to the Liverpool Echo, quote, Liverpool attacker may be fighting for his future after Jurgen Klopp transfer admission, unquote. So in a presser, Jurgen Klopp mentioned that Fabio might have to go out on loan. He did mention this, so that started the speculation he might go out on loan. Who knows? He might stick at Liverpool. Jurgen Klopp had a lot of great things to say about Fabio Carvalho. Basically, in my mind, in my opinion, he thinks of him as a player for the future. But I don't see him playing in the meantime at Liverpool. I actually think he will go out on loan. So I am buying this story. I am absolutely buying this story that Fabio Carvalho could be going out on loan. I think it's more likely than not. So the story, I think, does have legs. It's been in several places. So again, I'm buying this story as well. So I put out a poll earlier today. I don't have that many votes, but the results so far are very interesting about Fabio. So this poll was, would you like Fulham to bring back Fabio Carvalho on loan? Yes, was it 29.7%? Only on a permanent deal was it 38.2%. And no, was that 32.1%. It's pretty split here, which is interesting. So the Fulham supporters, based on what I'm seeing, have been split. I do have one comment from James Doughton. He actually says, no thanks. Not been playing for a year. Back to the championship and get some game time. Show everyone you can do it again. So that's from James. So there is also speculation that Red Bull Leipzig could be interested in taking him on loan. And we'll see what happens on this. But if I'm Fulham Football Club, I would like to see Fabio back. I would like to see him back on a permanent deal. I wouldn't want him on a loan deal. So that's where I'm separating it. If it's a loan only and I'm Fulham Football Club, I'm not interested. Not interested in making a player better for Liverpool. Not interested at all. I'm only interested in Fulham Football Club. If they could strike a deal to get Fabio back here permanently, I'm all in. I'm all in. I like the player. I believe in second chances. I know that there are a lot of Fulham supporters that are going to be listening to this and say, Russ, no, no, leave it alone. Leave him alone. We've been there, done that. Well, like I said, I believe in giving someone a second chance. If he wanted to come back and he wanted to be Fulham's version of Wilfred Zaha, bring it on. Only on a permanent deal. I would not do a loan deal. So if the story is correct and it's a loan deal, I'm out. I'm totally out. I don't want a loan deal with Fabio Carvalho. Only a permanent deal. If that's not part of it, then I'm out. Don't want it. I don't want him. I don't want him that bad. I would want him permanently, though. And he's such a young player that I would totally bring back Fabio. Totally would do it. But only if this was permanent. Okay. Coming up next to end this inaugural episode of Fulham Media Buzz, I'm going to be talking about some speculation in the Sun that broke today. Okay, to end this episode of Cottage Talk's Full Media Buzz for May the 30th, 2023, I'm going to talk about this article I just saw recently today. And according to the Sun, Fulham are working on a £2 million deal for Romanian teenage sensation Andre Borza. So I'm going to read from the article and I'm going to share my thoughts. Do I buy the story? Am I going to sell it? And do I think this would be something that Fulham should do? So here's the article from The Sun. Full force, Fulham working on $2 million transfer for 17-year-old wonder kid who graduated from Georgie Haji Academy. Fulham working on a £2 million deal for Romanian teenage sensation Andre Borza. The 17-year-old left back currently plays in his native country's top division for Ferrol Constanta, who won their first Superliga title this season. Borza, an under-20 international, scored 3 goals with as many assists during a historic campaign for the club. Sun Sport understands that the colleges have had scouts monitoring the defender and feel now is the time to bring him to West London to further develop his potential. Borza signed his professional contract with Ferrol last summer, expiring in June 2026. Fulham's main concern of sealing the deal is interest from Dutch giants PSV, who are also preparing a move for him. Fulham need new recruits, with Loney's Levin Kurzawa and Cedric Soros returning to PSG and Arsenal respectively this summer. It means they have just one recognized left back in Anthony Robinson. However, it is believed Borza would be loaned out next season with a view to getting a more first-team experience in one of Europe's top 5 divisions. Okay, so that's from The Sun. So this is interesting. You're talking about a very young left back from Romania. Do I buy the story? It's The Sun. I have a hard time with The Sun. But I'm going to buy it because there's so much detail in this story. I'm going to say I'm going to buy the validity of this. It's still transfer speculation, but I'm buying it. So let's go with the idea that this is true, that Fulham are trying to make a deal for this young left back. The part of it that I'm not sure about is sending him out on loan. Now, 17 years old, I do understand that. If this is true, could this be part of a new strategy with Fulham? Buying young players and sending them out on loan, getting the experience, and coming back to Fulham Football Club. Haven't done it recently, bringing in players specifically, buying them, and then taking them out on loan. It's interesting. I was thinking, could this be part of a new strategy for Fulham Football Club? I don't know, but I do find this whole story interesting. I'm all about bringing in young players. If this player has been scouted and let's say the speculation is true and they're interested for £2 million, is it worth the gamble? I say yes. And I understand what their intention would be if it's true that to send him out on loan. I guess I'm not against it if it does develop him into a quality player. If that also tells me he's not ready, he's coming from Romania, so it kind of makes sense. So if I really look at it, I'm not against the strategy here if it's to be true from the story I just read in The Sun. We shall see. It's silly season. Who knows what's true or untrue? I'm just going to read the stories out, share my thoughts on them, and we'll see how the cards play out. But I found that one interesting, and I wanted to share that to end this inaugural episode of Cottage Talks Full Media Bus. And today, it is May the 30th, 2023. Okay. Well, that's going to do it for this episode of Cottage Talk. As always, please do subscribe on YouTube and Apple Podcasts. If you liked this episode, please leave a comment on Twitter or on Facebook. Let me know, because I'm going to be doing several of these shows, and I hope people like them. I just want to shed light on the stories and have a conversation about them. I will have co-hosts joining me on some of these episodes as well. This was the inaugural one, so I wanted to do it by myself and just record it. But you will be able to respond live to several of these episodes of Fulham Media Bus. Okay. Well, that's going to do it for this episode. My name is Russ Goldman. Thank you, as always, for watching and listening to Cottage Talk, now part of the TalkSport Fan Network.